Martin, thank you, sir. Hello and hello again. Looks like we're back doing it again. Welcome to Living Strong, where I'm your host, A. Prophet Johnson. Talking about just being strong, folks. Be strong in the Lord and in the power of His might. Look like we've had a bumping around week and doing whatever we want to do and everything else, however which way it want to turn out. Lots going on in the land, lots going on in the world. Truly, we're living in the last days. Somewhere down the line, something's going on. Something is happening somewhere, unbeknownst, undemand. There's no more complaints. There's no more jurisdiction and no more laws or whatever the case may be. The Bible says that in the last days, that many would not take heed to sound doctrine, that they would give over to itching ears and spirits of seduction, that the love of many would wax cold, and that the heart of men would fail them because of fear. What we're experiencing is great fear in the land, and this fear is unprecedented to mankind. It is what we've spoken for years. The first to spearhead it, as everybody follow through the internet and social media, whatever you want to call your book on the face that you got there. But however which way we dealt with the four amigos, and we exposed hatred and racism, and therefore on top of that the bigotry and the murder, what we're seeing is cataclysmic demonic forces operating in Chicago, to where the African-American, I don't know what he is, I don't know whatever they are, whatever species of a human being that we are, to destroy each other from the Negronian dynasty of the motherland known as Africa, that black woman, her sons are destroying themselves like the apple dumpling gangs, And the Sugar Hill, rap, whatever the case may, it don't matter. It's just another one bites the dust. Queen is in the house, so why don't we just go ahead and resurrect Murphy and Eddie, whatever the guy's name or something. It doesn't matter, because what's happening right now is this outpour of demonic forces, this horde of seduction. Demons coming in everywhere. I wish I could talk about demonology and preach on demons and their operations and how they are influencing the mind of people all over the world, down the young children, talking about this crazy stuff with these book faces, and they looking at these aberrism or whatever these things are, and they are killing themselves, young girls, committing suicide, cutting themselves, locked into some screen. And as Deke said before he passed away, Brother Roberts, he said, surely that internet is the way up, a worldwide way up. That black widow has the whole world trapped in her spider's net. Kudos to Zuckerberg and all them others, whoever they are, TikToks and those them guys. Folks, brothers and sisters in Christ, I don't know how to explain this to you. This is something that is so simple, even a fool shouldn't err. Can y'all not see the pseudo-relational mechanism of how Satan has infiltrated the hearts, the minds of families, children, Christians, to where they display their lives in an open forum before the family in the world to become more of what they are displaying and more of what they are? So they send down through the pipe the subliminal messages that pop up on your screen so that you can purchase or buy or get the likes or move this stuff in an unbeknownst way being watched by the all-seeing eye that rests on the dollar bill. And on top of that, you having to go to work, struggle in life, go to the dollar store, and then make a living and dealing with issues and situations to where these things and entities and spirits are gateways and doorways that you are inviting into your house, and these demon spirits come in. And they talk to, what is this about this pornography stuff? Good Lord. And they talk, what is this pornography stuff that's on some internet deals that they're watching? Degrading of human life. That's what happened to the bishop in the church. Living a secret life. That's why we couldn't prosper. Look at what's happening to the Catholic Church. The exposure of young men in the Boy Scout. Look at lesbianism and homosexuality and alternative lifestyles. And the marriage of man and man and women with women working that which is unseemly in the sight and the presence of the Lord. And we honor God and expect God to just look away. There's no guidelines for COVID-19 at no ball games. The world is open up again. The Russian roulette doth run and turns upon every man, woman, boy, and girl. White supremacy supreme. The resurrection from the grave of the Almighty Son of Man, Caucasian, white, 45, back alive with all that jive to skin our hide, President Donald Trump. It would be so nice to just have a great evil president again. Sam in wrath, the destruction, laughing to our heads falling off with the cinnamon bun toast and the Manchurian candidates running the nation with pride and touchlessness. No voting rights, no George Floyd, no Haitians, just bring us the Caribbeans. Oh, brothers and sisters in Christ, Africa, bewildered land. Woo! The truth is going to spread. Jerusalem, I know that they that say that they are Jews, but truly are not, but of the household in the synagogue of Satan. Seven churches, Thyatira, Philadelphia, Sardis. Oh, can we reach you? How about it? But where are we now? Be strong in the time of death, in the time of life, in the time of agony, in the time of battle. Be strong. What has happened to the prayerlessness church? Oh, I feel for you, brothers and sisters. They won't tell y'all. The truth tellers in the house, Cap, I'm already vexed. Whew. I don't even want to read this. I really don't. James chapter number 1, verse number 2, my brethren, count it all joy when you fall into divers temptation, many kinds of traps, people setting you up, talking about you, stabbing you in the back. This is what God is saying. The first thing, excuse me, I want you to do is to be happy about it. God said, be happy when you're going through hell, because knowing I'm in the midst of it with you. Knowing this, that the trying of your faith worketh patience, something inside of your mind and your heart is calling you to higher heights and deeper depths. Your faith is unflinching, unshakable. You walk on through knowing that the Lord is your shepherd and you shall not want. Trust in the Lord. Hallelujah. With all your heart, lean not to thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy path. Do you want to live, Bill? Do you want to live, Clarissa? Do you want to live, Agatha? James, will you not live? Richard! Oh, live! Here we go. The trying of your faith worketh patience, but let patience have her. Why is she a female? Because she produces, patience produces. She is your best friend when you're on the fishing bank or when you're out hunting deer, rabbit, or squirrel, and then patience comes in to feed you. Thank you so much for the analysis. Here it goes, but let patience have her perfect work. Even on your job, I don't have time to explain patience, okay? And why Prophet Johnson? Because I don't like her. I really don't. I don't like to date patient. I don't like to go out with her. I don't like to be her friend. You know what I mean? Why? That's just me, not you guys. Because patience is it irritates me. You know, go to a restaurant, you gotta have patience, right? Well, we still know how to have it. And still, patience is my best friend. She won't let me go. She said, I'm in control of this. I run this show. You gonna do exactly what I say, when I say it, how I say it, because ain't nothing gonna move until I do. So that's the best girl to go out with, okay? But be patient with her. Here it is. But let patience have her perfect work, that you may be perfect in entire wanting nothing, which means she's going to complete, is going to complete your faith, is going to work with patience to be strong, to complete what it is, your end goal, your dream, your life. You cannot give up. Oh God, I don't have nobody to listen to me. Help me, Jesus. Listen, folks. You got to keep striving. I know that there are times we're dug in, we get lazy. As I talked about on the other day, we don't want to do nothing, don't want to clean up, don't want to work. But we've got to continue to have a heart and a mind that say, I'm going to get it done. I'm going to strive for it. Oh, nobody chastises me more. Then the poor folks around here, Captain, done kicked me up so bad. About $2 that I need to go and look at. And on top of that, I'm trying to show you how folks will help you if you let them. God will use people to give you a swift kick in the butt to get you moving, folks. And it's like torment. They don't have to say nothing. They can just walk by and look at you with the eye. Do you remember how it used to be? And then focus. And you're sitting there with the guilt and the burden saying, I've got to get it done. I've got to move. Whatever your goal, your dream, you cannot just stop and be lazy. There is a spirit in this land, folks, y'all not hearing me. This spirit is testing me as hard for laziness. Women that don't want to work, they want to trip the system, want a free ride. And here it is, the government tripping. Ooh, You dummy dims, I'm here to let y'all know, you dummy dims, y'all getting them old fogey stogies back in there. You playing that same old game, more dirtier than Raph, talking about checking out stuff on the poor people to make it a gateway to get to the rich people, talking about $600, that's a lie from the pit of hell. Talking about $10,000, a lie from the pit of hell. You witch hazel, let me tell you something, and you gauntlet getting, warlock, you gauntlet getting warlock, and you witch hazel, heifer, let me tell you something, you bastards from hell, and you heifers from hell, that's destroyed and think God don't see your demonic intentions and your spirit from the church to the Congress to the White House to the outhouse to the schoolhouse, from your house to my house, from he that sweep around his own front door and don't be minding yours. We are in a time now to where these demons are about to eat this world apart. Y'all don't have no idea. Don't worry about China. Don't worry about Russia. To hell with a war. God bless a nuclear war. Blow this baby up. No, America is going to destroy herself just like she's doing from the inside, through the church not saying nothing, through hatred and racism and lying and cheating and stealing and grieving and not caring and hunting black men and locking them up. This is a hypocrisy-philiatical nation if you ever seen it. Why? Because we forgot our God. They forgot where they came from. Black people in position, in little stores, in little restaurants, in little whatever they open up, are just as bad. In little conservative offices, in the little cars on the station of the people on ICE lease are just as bad and nasty and can be low down and dirty and conniving and undermining as white people. Black people are just as bad. Y'all in trouble. Keep your family. Keep your friends, keep your money, keep your job, keep your honey, and your doo-wop, the wop, the wop, the that thing. Cause baby, honey, sugar doll, brother, stud, OG, you on the Titanic, baby, brother, sisters in Christ. The drain plug is pulled. Hope you got your lifeboats and your life raft, because we got a paddle to land. Y'all have no idea. I've warned you. I've told you. The great migration is coming. They're coming from all over the land to America. You don't see the warnings of California. People don't care. The fish life, the animals, we don't care. The manipulation, long we can manipulate and get our programs and our TV shows and our cooking shows and our animal shows and have somebody to watch us on the Disney Channel. We are right on the news. It's nothing but baking the cake. We alive. It doesn't matter. We got our 2 million watchers, remember? Look at the Word of God. It seems like I've been here forever, don't it? Look like all my time is up now, doesn't it? Here it is. I may have a minute or two. Here it is. But let patience, verse number 4, have her perfect work, that you may be perfect and entire, wanting nothing. If any of you lack wisdom, let him ask of God, that give it to all men liberally and upbraid it not, and it shall be given him. Wisdom. This is what is being spread. That's, see, life. Wisdom going to teach you about life. But let him ask in faith, nothing wavering, for he that wavereth is like a wave of the sea, driven with the wind and tossed. He vacillates back and forth, to and fro. For let that man think that he shall receive anything of the Lord. Okay, let not that man think that he shall receive anything of the Lord. Get on down the road. You don't have no faith with it. Faith coming by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. We walk by faith and not by sight. A double-minded man is unstable in all of his ways. That's true. How many of us are double-minded? A whole lot of us. We think that we're not, but we are. Some of us are triple-minded, quadruple-minded. Here it is. Let the brother of low degree rejoice in that he is exalted. Humble yourself. Why? That brother is to rejoice. Because God is going to exalt him. He is already exalted. Because he's not high-minded, heady. But the rich in that he is made low. Because as the flower of the grass, he shall pass away. Now, when you hear this stuff, God talk about rich. There's nothing wrong with riches and wealth. God wants you to have that, prosper and be in good health, even as your soul prosper. But God know what the deal is with riches. The preachers are admitting it now, that money is the only thing on earth and in life that is second to God, even greater than Satan. Money is second to the creator of heaven and earth. The preachers are coming out with it. They must be listening to Living Strong. I don't know where they're getting it from, but they're preaching it out on the radios and television and cootie up ways now. The power of the almighty dollar. What happened to almighty God? The money even trust in God, and they lying. I ain't got no help. If I had a church, here it is. God said they're going to pass away. Just like the flower. You see, rich. God, I wish I could talk to y'all rich folks. But y'all laugh at me to score on those yachts and them trips and got their white wine and all your liquor and stuff. Boy, y'all laugh at me to score in the mansions. I would too. Look at that poor little black man. Oh, they're preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ and trying to tell us something about life. Honey, he can't tell us nothing in a bathing suit, you know, lingerie type. He can't tell us nothing but hanging out with one half pad on one side with one eyelash sticking to hell and the other one trying to reach heaven. And, you know, the God is with us. And don't have no idea that I agree with y'all. 100%. I can never and shall never be able to tell you anything, and you should never ever be able to listen to anyone like me, because I am considered a complete fool to y'all. Only one thing, sir. One thing, ma'am, it is appointed unto man once to die, and after that, the judgment. If you can just remember that, ask your money whether you go into heaven or it's going to take you straight to hell, because this fool tried to tell you. Listen to me, rich boy, richy rich. Here it is. Captain, you can rush me when you're ready. For the sun is no sooner risen with the burning heat, but it withered the grass, and the flower thereof falleth, and the grace of the fashion of it perish. So also shall the rich man fade away in his ways. You don't see it. I know this. Sir, do I need to say anything else? It's going to happen just like this, sir. Your Rolls Royce is old. Your Bentley's no good. And your castle got castle weeds growing in it. You just didn't know that I was the spider and we are the spider that was sitting in the wall on your corner. Spider's the only one getting in the king's houses. There it is. Captain gave me start to finish. Y'all excuse me, we're going to do this and close out. Verse number 12, blessed is, James chapter number 1, blessed is the man that endureth temptation, for when he is tried, he shall receive the crown of life. Do you hear that? That's what we're after. I've got a crown of life. You do too, brothers and sisters in Christ. This time, y'all got to get on the good foot now. I done told y'all this cootie of Jesus Christ stuff going to kill y'all. Y'all better get away from that cootie Jesus. That hell-raising, lying Christian Jesus Christ they preaching out there, that's a lie from the pit of hell. Those folks going to mess y'all up with this sweet Jesus cootie up, false prophet sending you lies through your mail and sending you these trinkets and gadgets. Y'all, you got, no, keep doing it. But keep doing it. Good Lord. He shall give thee to receive the crown of life which the Lord hath promised to them that love him. Let no man say when he is tempted, I am tempted of God, for God cannot be tempted with evil, neither tempted he any man. But let every man is tempted when he is drawn away of his own lust or desire and enticed. You know what lust is? Greed, desire, enticed. But when lust hath conceived, it bringeth forth sin, and when sin is finished, it bringeth forth death. Don't let that little smooch cause you to get your little pooch killed up. It's bad to die over a little bit of Wang Tang. And you know, come on now, a little bit of that dang-a-lang. It's bad to die over a little dang-a-lang Wang Tang. Come on now, tell them Prophet Joseph said that. Here it is. Every good gift and every perfect gift is from above. That's where the blessing comes from. Come back and preach it, boy. You're rushing me. I can feel it. And come it down from the Father of lights. Every good gift with whom is no variableness, neither shadow of turning. Can't nobody stop that blessing. Of his own will begat he us with his word. God got us through the word. The devil didn't do it. He can't do nothing about it. He mad because we are word up. He mad because the word came down. He mad because we are the word central. He mad because you are that living word now. After the living word left, he came unto his own, but his own received him not. But many as received him, to them gave he the power to become the sons of God. He said, not only will I be with you, but I will be in you. I'm not going to leave you comfortless, but I'm going to send a comforter. I wish I had time, but my time is running out. Of his own will, Captain, I got 5 seconds. He with his word begat us, the word of truth, that we should be a kind of first fruit of his creature. You're the first, the head, and not the tail, blessed, and not cursed, called out, sought out, chosen of God. The deliverer is in the house. I don't know about you, but I got plans to move on one day, and one day, Lord, it's going to be over. One day, Lord, we won't have to worry. That's my time. Thank you for yours. This is the climax of Be Strong. I'll see you guys tomorrow night.